In this tutorial, we will learn to create this object from scratch. For this object creation, we will have to use combination of surface modeling and 3D modeling techniques. So watch this complete tutorial to understand this concept perfectly. If you want to watch more such type of videos, then please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. So at first click here on new, then select part, click on OK. Then to activate surface toolbar, right click here, take your cursor to tabs and click here on surfaces. So here surface toolbar got activated. So at first in this object, we will have to create this half spherical surface. So to create that half spherical surface, click here on revolved surface. Then I want it to be vertical, so click here on front plane. Then click here on center point arc. Then click here on this origin point. Take your cursor on this side. Ensure that line is straight. Click, take your cursor below. And once angle of 90 degrees is shown, click there. So here this arc is created. Then click here on smart dimension. Select this arc. Click. Specify radius of 500, enter. Then we will need one center line for revolve. So click here on this arrow near line and click on center line. Then click at this center point, take your cursor below and click. Then right click and exit sketch. Then ensure that you have selected this blind and angle is 360 degree. Then click on OK. Then zoom to fit. So here half spherical bowl is created. Then if you see this object's top view, you will see that this is actually a spiral curve. So we will create this spiral curve. So to create spiral curve, click here on curves and click here on helix and spiral. Then click here on this arrow and click here on top plane. Then at first we will have to create one circle. So click here on circle. Click on this origin point. Take your cursor away and click. Then click here on smart dimension. Select this circle. Take it away and click. Then specify diameter of 10. Enter. Then click here on close. Then zoom there. Then click here and select spiral. Then specify pitch of 10, then number of revolution as 10. Okay, we will have to increase the pitch. So we will make it 50, enter. Okay, 50 into 10, that is 500 radius. Then click on OK. Click outside. Then we will have to convert this spiral into sketch. For that, click here on sketch. Click on sketch. Then again click here. Click on top plane. Then click here on convert entities and select this spiral and click on OK. Then OK. So here this sketch is created. Then to project this sketch on this face, click here on features, click on curves and click here on project curve. Then select this option sketch on faces. Then select this spiral sketch. And select this face. So here it has been projected. Right click, OK. Then we will hide unwanted objects. For that, click here on this object and click here on hide. Click here on this object and hide. So here this curve is created. Zoom to fit and isometric. Then to create rod, we will have to create one plane. So click here on reference geometry, click on plane, then zoom there, select this curve and select this point. So here this plane is created. Right click, OK. Then we will sketch one circle here, click here on sketch, click on sketch, select this plane. OK, plane was already selected, so it got selected automatically. Then click here on sketch 4 and click on normal 2. Then click here on circle, click on this origin point, Take your cursor away and click. Then click on Smart Dimension. Select this circle, take it away, click. Then specify diameter of 20, enter. Then click on OK. Then hide this plane, click on this plane and hide. Then to convert it into 3D, click here on Features and click here on Swept Boss Base. Then select this circle and this curve and click on OK. Click outside. Then hide this curve. Hide. So here this shape is created. Then next is to create that curve rod. So for that, what we will do, we will copy this curve from sketch 1. So just click here on sketch, click on sketch, then click here and click on this front plane, because that curve was made on front plane. Then click here on normal, then click here on this arrow so that it will show this sketch 1. Click on this sketch 1 and click here on convert entities. So here that curve is created. Click on OK. Click outside. Then again we will create one plane. Click here on features. Click here on reference geometry. Click on plane. Then select this curve and select this point. Click on OK. Click outside. Then again click here on sketch. Then again sketch. Select this plane. Then click here on circle. Click on this origin point, take your cursor away, click. Click on smart dimension, select this circle, click and make it 20 diameter, enter. Then click on OK. Then hide this plane, click on this plane and click here on hide. Then again features, swept boss base, then select this circle and this curve. Click on OK. OK, actually it is giving some problem because of this merging. So what we will do, we will increase the radius of that circle which we used to create this spiral so that they will not merge. So I will just cancel it. Then I will edit this helix. Then click here on this arrow before helix. Click here on sketch 2 and click here on edit sketch. Then we will make this diameter as 20, enter, click on OK. Give it some time for update. Now again we will try it. So again swept boss base, select this circle and this curve and click on OK. OK, it is created perfectly now. Then we will have to create circular pattern of these rods. For that click here on arrow below linear pattern and click here on circular pattern. Then select this rod, then click here, then we will have to select axis. So we will take axis as per the sketch 1. So click here on this arrow and click here on sketch 1. So here it has created that axis automatically. Then define quantity, suppose I will make it 25, enter. And angle to fill is 360 degree and ensure that equal spacing is selected. Then click on OK. Again it is giving error. We will just try to give different quantity. Suppose we will make it 30. OK. Still it is giving error. OK, again it may be because of that only. So what we will do, we will reduce it. Suppose we will make it 20. OK. OK. With 20 it has been created perfectly. So we will try to increase also quantity. Suppose we will edit it and suppose we will make it 50. Okay. So give it some time to generate that object because it is a very complicated object. So here with 50 also it is working. So for some quantities actually because of some intersection it gives problem for creation. So you can try different quantities. Then one last will be this circular ring. So for that we will use revolved boss base. So click here on revolved boss base. We will use this right plane. We want some vertical plane. We will use right. Click here normal to. Then click here on circle. And click here in line with this origin point. Click, again smart dimension, click, click, 20, enter. Then select the center point, this origin point, click, give distance of 500, so same as the radius of this curve. Then we will need one center line, click here, press escape. Then click here on this arrow, click on center line, click on this origin point, take it below, click, right click, select, click on OK. So here this revolve of 360 degrees created, select blind and give angle of 360, click on OK. So here this object is created. Then to apply different material, just right click here on material. And suppose I will choose this brass. So yeah, this object is created perfectly. If you want to learn SolidWorks from very basic level, then link to complete playlist is given here. Please like, share and subscribe by clicking here on this icon. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.